Hello and welcome to Red's Tablet channel. In this tutorial, we will talk about Popper.js, a cool JavaScript library to help you with positioning your HTML element very quickly, especially if you have something like notification box or message on your website. Let's go check it out. So here is the project page of Popper.js, which you can get the example code and demo on each feature. Now let's head to the GitHub page and download the latest release of Popper.js to start this tutorial. Once downloaded, the library is in your dist folder. There are a couple types of release, but if you want to import it to your web page with a script tag, you will need to use the one in UMD or Universal Module Definition folder. Now I have copied popper.js to the web directory and imported it with a script tag. And here is the simple HTML page with a button. The orange div represents all the data elements that might be on the page. Now suppose that I want to add a pop-up message when I click the button. Let's add a div element. And then make it hidden and show it when the button is clicked. Now you see that our pop-up element is displaying as a block and not really floating over. Normally we will need to add some more JavaScript and CSS style to deal with the positioning, but with popper.js is a whole lot easier. Just create a new popper object as a div element or anything. And then pass the element that you want to use as a reference. In this case is the button. And next the pop-up element. And finally, the option. There are lots of options available, and the first one we'll try is the placement. Let's set it to topped. And that's it. You need to tell which placement that you need, and the popper will do the rest. Another awesome feature of popper.js is it will do the flipping for you when the pop-up is leaving the viewport. Of course, you can customize the flipping behavior by adding modifiers in the option and tell popper.js the direction that you will allow the flipping to occur. You can discover the documentation page and try other interesting modifiers. For example, you can set the offset of the pop-up position by adding offset modifier like this. Finally, popper can return the information about positioning of the pop-up element. You can pass the onCreate callback function and add the data object like this. So that's it. I hope this video should give you some ideas about popper.js and hope you guys like this video. As always, please don't forget to like or subscribe to support us. See you on the next video. Bye!